Yo, and in terms of the South African music, where do you think it is? Where do you think it's going?
I think South African music is in a great place. Mm-hmm. You got artists like AKA and artists like AKA and AKA among others.
Unpacking the journey of AKA's career has been quite the mission, not because of lack of information, but because he had made such a huge mark in the South African music that extends all over the continent of Africa. AKA's musicianship transcended the sphere of South African hip-hop. Experiencing his eras were nothing short of amazing, whether he was ranting amidst releasing levels, to standing up for the rights of South African students within the Bovermania rollout. Let's rewind and dive into the artistry of the Supa Mega. Born in the city of Cape Town on the 28th of January 1988, Kiernan Jarryd Forbes had a passion for music and dancing at a very young age and would often sing with his dad. And having been an avid Michael Jackson fan, he'd never miss a chance to perform and dance for family members.
So another thing that used to happen when you were a kid in Cape Town is your grandparents used to wheel you out, like, come and sing for the people,
yes,
right?
Yes, 100%.
What was your go-to song that you used to perform for?
My go-to song was ding 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 ding. Any of you okay? Yeah, you know, in my grandparents' house, there used to be like a lounge. And then there was steps, and then I was like, okay, put the music on. And then I just like jump and like stand and like sing. And yeah, man, that was my vibe.
But it was only in the city of Johannesburg where the 14-year-old St. John student took a particular interest in becoming a hip hop artist. Looking up to hip hop icons such as Pro Kid and Kanye West, Kiernan, along with five friends, shared a love for hip hop and would often participate in beatboxing sessions. The crew went down to three members shortly thereafter, namely Sizwe Mpofu Walsh, who went by the name Vice Versa, Ntlantla Makena as Greyhound, and Kiernan, who we now know as AKA. The trio decided to go by the name of Entity, with a former member by the name of Ndogozo Books Mazibuko coming back to produce for the collective against his parents' wishes. Soon enough, Entity were invited to perform at various events. One event in particular, which was hosted in Orange Farm, gave the group the opportunity to be signed to a record label called Creative Record.
Anyway, crazy story. And then he said, okay, come. Yo, I'm from Creative Kingdom, this record label. Come, let's have a meeting. I want to sign you guys. On the way home. Oh my God, we're finna get signed. You know? And we had this meeting, and then we do this thing. And then eventually, so they're like, all right, cool, we're gonna make an album, what. But they were so smooth, they're so smart. They made us pay for it.
How?
Yeah. No, I'm sure, so we had to like go ask our parents for like dough.
Wow.
Yeah, we had to like, they finessed our parents out of like maybe 202 clips.
Damn.
Yeah, and we did an album. It was dope. We didn't make a single cent.
Mm.
Nothing.
Books and AKA had lived close to one another, and because of their love for beatboxing, they both learned to master beats using Fruity Loops workstation. Their first production for Entity being Touch and Go.
Close the door and turn the sound up. Drown myself in rhythm and cleanse the bad luck. The music system drenched my system, left me feeling
depressed. And released the single First Gear.
The coastal rule one, the big dogs roll with the subs in the back so the bass can attack your chest so you never get rest in the sack. Nevertheless, let me get on to rule two.
They released their first and only album, Royal School of Hip Hop, in 2005, with Touch and Go being nominated for a Kora Award for Best African Hip Hop. Touch and Go was Entity's most successful single and birthed a new form of AKA, the producer. Shortly after the release of Royal School of Hip Hop, the group disbanded in 2006, and in 2007, Kiernan and Books decided to go even further with their newfound talent of producing, linking up with a fellow friend by the name of Kabelo Kamzambata, who was already an established radio personality and DJ on 5FM, gave them a chance to get much more exposure in the music industry. Kiernan went on to study sound engineering to brush up his producing skills and worked at SABC Studios within the same period. The trio went by the name of Ivy League, and a co-sign by a hip-hop heavyweight by the name of Pro Kid proved that the production crew were a force to be reckoned with. Speaking to Medium.com, Pro Kid briefly explained how he got to work with Ivy League. The first time was at Capello's in the CBD. I believe that you can never be larger than life because you'll never know where the next thing will come from. When that kid Kiernan spoke to me, I could feel him. I was like, okay, F this party, let's get into the car. When Kiernan played a CD with beats on it initially meant for WHP, Pro Kid immediately liked the first beat and took it right there. The beat we now know to be a record named Bampa. And from then on, the crew went on to produce multiple songs on Pro Kid's albums. Pro Kid's relationship with Ivy League helped to advance his sound and break into previously unexplored territory. With Jozy making worldwide sounds such as Crank, Ivy League merged those sounds and other influences such as house and Kwaito. Suddenly, Kwaito and house music heads had a firm favorite from the rap world to add onto their music library. And that's what made Ivy League ahead of its time. Other works from the crew include Proverbs' Kimberly Diamond. From a ring your wife gets, cause it symbolizes the one you're pretending to spend your life with. Reasons, Tlaubone. Kuli Chana's Zwak Stickum. Kuli Chana's No More Hunger. No more hunger. It's all about the things we do, things and things we do. For the saga, no more hunger. It's all about the things we do, things and things we do. AKA's 24/7/366 EP. And of course, his debut album, Alter Ego. AKA released his self-co-produced debut album, Alter Ego, on July 2010, with his debut single, I Want It All, that featured the biggest rap stars, Kuli Chana and Pro Kid. With this track, he announced his intentions early in his rap career. There was no second place for him. It's either he got it all from the sky to the ground, or he got nothing. Rich, I want it all from the sky to the ground when they hit the floor. So my dick got deep up, vice us all. So much of money, but vice us all. Did you never spot a chase us all? Boom, sell up, vice us all. The single choice was a strategic move on his end, as commercial hip-hop was a vernacular game, and we hadn't seen a solo English rapper reach that scale yet. So having the most prominent Kasi lyricist and the hottest Motswako rapper on the song, I Want It All proved to be the single that certified him as the hip-hop artist to be on the lookout for. The second single from the album, Victory Lap, showed a different side to AKA. He wanted to release a single that had crossover appeal without sounding like anything that was being produced at the time. And icing on the cake was that the remix featured heavyweights Dumi, WHP, and Amo. Followed by All I Know, where AKA details the pressures of relationships in the midst of stardom and his constant traveling and work.
You're gonna be like, see, there you go again. That's why I'm in the club on my fucking BBM. That's why I'm never trusted when I'm in DBN. We work it out, then we go right back to the beginning.
Bang served as the final single from the album, another song that featured Kuli Chana. And getting that stamp of approval not only once but twice for your debut album from a rapper like Kuli Chana proved that AKA was really here to stay.
When I gave Kiernan that co-sign, you know, it wasn't like it's something I had to do for the game or for the culture or for, you know, it was just something I'd also learned from Jabba, you know, I had to carry on tradition that you believe in somebody, you share, you know. So that's all I did, and I also realized, I got to a place where I realized that his star was rising, you know what I mean, and my position in his life is to be the big bro,
With the certified classic debut album that featured some of the biggest rappers, including Luis Okola on the skits, Alter Ego broke records with singles simultaneously reaching number one on music charts of both 5FM and Metro FM, radio stations with two completely different target markets, earning his bragging rights as a rapper by providing guest verses to Zeus and Stogie T on Das Was Up.
How many gods we touch, they coming up for air. So in the bars we trust, in the cuts we plan. The cost to beat the boss, too much to spend. The more we running out of things to give. Forgive, I'ma do when I see fit. My dreams came true as a grown-ass kid. Now everything I do is under the spotlight. But you can never be the new kid on the block twice.
DJ Vigilante's God's Will.
Lord, give me solid gold. Give me endless knowledge and wisdom. Friend or foe, how do we go? Who knows the difference?
And on the 2012 collaboration mixtape, exclusive with DJ Fanatic, Alter Ego earned AKA a Channel O Award for Most Gifted Hip Hop for Victory Lap and two Summer Awards, including Male Artist of the Year.
Yo, what's up? This is AKA. Thank you to everybody who voted. Thank you to all my fans, as you can see, Best Hip Hop. Thank you to Channel O, Ripple Films, Show Love Music. You know, my family, thank you very much. We love you. Peace!
His sophomore album, Levels, reached number one on the 16th of June 2014 on iTunes for pre-orders and was only due to be released in June. The album cover, centered with the boombox, symbolized music being the center of his life and the pyramids as the personal development of the rapper. The album was released on the 18th of July and had featured a whopping 7 singles dating from 2012. The album saw him experiment with the house and hip-hop hybrid. Control sampled Jera's Maui.
Got that goose in the boot, no dash. Caught a tank, 2 a.m., puff, puff, pass.
Congratulate, which was his most expensive music video, costing $250,000 to make, sampled Harrison Crumb's Ride. Jealousy sampled Martin Slovaig's track of the same name. All Eyes on Me sampled Brenda Fassie's Nyaksaba. And Sim Dope sampled Mr. O's Mama Africa. Levels saw AKA touring UK, Australia, America, and the entire African continent, and featured in other African artists' hip-hop songs such as N-Word Remix, a first we had ever seen on a mainstream scale from a South African hip-hop artist. It was also during this era where we saw the blooming relationship between AKA and Delez. Speaking of his comeback in the music scene, Leslie stated, "I wanted to move to the US, but I was clowning around and partying. AKA said to me I was the business and needed to get focused, that music is what I do well. He started by getting me onto his big hit Control featuring Muggs. I then used the winnings to build my own studio and did Heaven featuring the two of them. From that song, I started recording this album." The duo became inseparable and recorded more records together, with AKA providing the services on the Lazer's albums with joints such as Heaven.
I'm pressed to death and this motherfucker has a question. Yeah. I'm in a seven. Now can you parallel in this motherfucker?
Yeah. Real stuff.
Let's go. I've been in the dungeon cooking up the real stuff. Stacking 50s and 100s, they gon' think I deal drugs. Two cups with the ammo, check my new collabo. North guy got the whole squad just to camo.
And Paid featuring Burna Boy.
These days I be going so hard through the threshold. Pull a couple shots of the XO. I need a body, got pockets on cholesterol. Check my dress code, about to do the breaststroke. Do the money, bitches get nothing from me.
Levels has since been certified 7x platinum, making it one of the highest selling hip-hop albums in the country. It gained him a strong following across the African continent, opened doors for him in the US and the UK, and had entrenched him as the most important player in the South African music scene. He dominated the South African radio airways and became the most played South African artist on radio. In 2015, he He released Baddest featuring Yanga, Hulichana and Burna Boy. The song became a hit and was followed with an all-female remix. He delivered the catchy hook on Reason's Yippie-Ki-Yay.
Pull up at the party and I'm sitting sideways. Dream so big, about to get a migraine. Niggas all in my face, Twitter my space. Party like a cowboy, Yippie-Ki-Yay. I take another shot, let my people dilate. Let the speakers vibrate.
In the same year, he released Dreamwork featuring Yanga, which was heavily co-signed by Snoop Dogg and has since been certified 5x diamond by the Recording Industry of South Africa, moving at least 1.5 million in sales. One time in which his performance on Live Amp served as the most watched performance on the show, trending for 24 hours on Twitter.
They be feeling that pressure. It's going down in the rip right now. Let me hear you sing right now. She be living with me.
And worked with the rising producer Anati on his debut single, The Saga.
Album, but they treat me like a legend. Listen to my old itch, that's my only pressure. City where the gold is, that's the holy man.
With their undeniable chemistry, the two decided to work on their next eras together in 2017. In July 2017, AKA joined forces with Anati and released the collaborative project Be Careful What You Wish For. The album followed a religious theme with biblical terminology on the lyrical content and brought together AKA's lyrical skills and Anati's elements of production and melody. The intro, Bryanston Drive, follows AKA's journey to success as he reflects on his come up, struggling to get by with a single mother, as well as his achievements and becoming friends with his idols.
I used to want the title as a freshman. Now all of my biggest idols are my best friends. Every instrumental got a death wish. Took my out the ghetto like the Fresh Prince.
The first single from the project, 10 Fingers, has AKA recognizing that he's been running the game for 10 years and his competition was not on his level. The second single, Don't Forget to Pray, debuted on Apple Music's Beats One radio show with Ebro. AKA was also honored as the first ever African-based artist to be named on BBC One Extra's coveted Hot for 2016 artist list. On Don't Forget to Pray, his opening lines are altogether boastful and dismissive.
Swag drip when you track kids in the wax trip for some smash. Classics for you burn. Three like a mad hits in the Tupperware.
At this point in his career, the rapper born as Kiernan Forbes no longer needs another hit. The conquest is done. He doesn't need another summer smash to solidify his place in SA rap's history books. The final single, Holy Mountain, is a slow-paced jam and it finds the two rappers talking about their blessings and how they were able to achieve them because of a higher power. Originally set to be released in May 2018, Touch My Blood was released in June 2018 and served as a follow-up to Levels.
Like, yeah. Touch My Blood.
Yeah, that's it. Because I used to go, I go to all the shows and somebody will see me and say, hey, Mega, Touch My Blood. Touch My Blood.
Okay.
And I thought, hey, Touch My Blood. It sounds nice. It's, you know, street slang. Mm. And it also represents, like, feel my music, feel my pain, feel my joy, feel my happiness. Feel my...
In the project, AKA continues to merge dance music and hip-hop through samples of EDM and house songs, a trend that started in his 2014 album, Levels. Touch My Blood was certified gold 1 week into its release and reached platinum status 5 months later in November. There were 7 singles released from the album between the years of 2016 and 2019. The first single, The World Is Yours, was released in December 2016 and sampled Boom Clap Bachelor's jam, Lop Stop Star. Shot Shot in Thailand, the visuals complemented the aesthetic of the single, which delivered a laid-back and mellow sound with soulful beats.
Yes, Daddy.
What?
Can you hear me? rendition of one of your songs that I can do.
Sing it for me.
Running out of things I can prove myself. Whether there's a win or never lose by myself. Every day they go ahead on us. Mama says she can pray for us. Cause I can do it on my own.
Inspired by the taste of his father's music, the second single, Kaifa's Song, which samples Kaifa Semenya's Matswale, is a tale of modern-day love narrated over 80s-type synths. The song sees him veer further away from the conventions of hip-hop, and this time, he lands squarely into the realm of disco pop. The song, like its predecessors, One Time and The World Is Yours, feature more singing than rapping from AKA. On Kaifa's Song, he capitalizes on a generation's obsession with nostalgia and delivers what is quite arguably one of his catchiest songs to date. Speaking to The Plug, AKA stated with Kaifa's Song, "I was trying to come of age as a songwriter. That was me announcing to the world that I'm a musician before anything else, and not just a rapper." He went on to release Star Signs, Sweet Fire, Beyonce, Jiga, and his most successful single, Fella in Versace. The song was included on the global Spotify playlist, is his most viewed music video, and spent 5 consecutive weeks at number 1 on both Metro FM and Ukozi FM's Top 40 chart. The World Is Yours and Kaifa's Song have since been certified 8x platinum. Following in the footsteps of his musical idol Kanye West with live orchestration, AKA continued to push the envelope with the ambitious idea of having a musical concert. Marking 10 years of his solo career in 2019, celebrating it took the form of a show unlike any he'd ever done before. He embarked a one-night-only concert with a 30-piece orchestra at the Sun Arena Times Square Casino in Pretoria. A first for a South African artist, performing all the greatest hits from his 4 albums, the show was such a success that DStv paid to make the show available on its streaming service, Showmax. Released in November 2020, the Bovomania EP served as his most polarizing project of work to date. He recorded the bulk of it during lockdown. Constructing the EP as a concept album, AKA was deliberate in referencing WWE, the most obvious example being the title and artwork. After becoming the first African artist and 7th rapper in the world to be featured on WWE, his love for wrestling served as an inspiration for this EP. The project received mixed reviews from critics, which is not surprising because his EP sounded like nothing we had ever heard. But that's what made AKA ahead of his time. Similar to Touch My Blood, which also received mixed reviews, it's music that is ahead of its time. His precision in perfecting his craft is what makes his discography grow on people. The Gemini Major produced Casino stands out like a sore thumb in the project with its sample of Route 94 My Love and the invigorous energy of Shoma Josie and Flame.
With the warmth of my... What up, Maya? You ready? Let's go!
On Monuments, featuring Grandmaster Ready D and Younger, AKA reflects on why he became an artist, backed by a minimal beat with Eric B and Rakim's sample of Paid in Full. Energy, featuring Gemini Major, sampled the calming and tingling lead pad of Nick Holder's classic Summer Days, floats over 808s and futuristic sound and melodies of AKA's verses. Between 2019 and 2020, AKA became even more vocal on social issues, which contributed in his fallout with Burna Boy. Not one to hold his tongue, AKA hopped on the remix to the now late Costa Titch's Ngalagata remix with the late Ricky Rick.
I am the king of the jungle, Julius Caesar. Cancel my people, cancel your visa. Nobody go enter. South is king, I've got an Eden, and I'm at the center. The public protector, talk out your rectum. Who's telling my sim? My middle finger, stand tall for the flag.
In his verse, the Supa Mega came to the defense of South Africans from the misguided Burna Boy. Costa Titch and AKA went on to release a joint project titled You're Welcome in 2021, a year before their passing. With Costa's use of old-school Kwaito samples and AKA's seasoned experience with sampling house productions, this was a chemistry that made so much sense. Their sounds and flows complemented each other and together released a cohesive 8-track project featuring Super Soft and Big Deal. AKA decided to record an album after his late fiance's passing, as music was an escape for him when it came to heartbreak and grief. Mass Country was the first album he had ever done that was finished way before its release date, and if you watch his latest interviews, you realize that Kiernan was a changed man who wanted to do better for himself. Having Kabelo Mabalane as his spiritual mentor and pastoral oversight, he became a much more spiritual person and spread positivity to everyone around him. The album cover encompassed everything that was truly him, including his love for his country.
Allowed me to...
How's Nasty doing?
He's amazing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean, me and him, like, we don't really speak, but I know that I respect him. Like, in fact, he's like the future. He's like... He's the next me.
I mean, he's got the same respect for you.
He's gonna take the game further than I could ever take the game.
He started the rollout of the album by dropping Lemon's Lemonade featuring Nasty C, which became an instant hit, surpassing KO's Sete on the radio charts. The knee-deep sampled Prada featuring Kulichana, Company featuring Nigerian artist and producer Kidominant, and the introductory track Last Time, a heart-wrenching reminder that this is, in fact, the last new release we would ever get from the rapper. The photo shoot leading to the release of the album was done 2 days before his passing, and the theme of the shoot he had chosen is still quite hard to grasp. He had never done a shoot like this in any of his previous works. His posthumous release had his fanbase, the Megacy, trend hashtag Kiernan Forbes for hours and amassing over 6 million streams within the first day of the album's release. A special billboard for the album release was displayed on Times Square in New York by Spotify. Hip-hop is what made AKA be crowned as the Prince of African Hip-Hop, but what made him the Supa Mega was his star power as a performing musician that led to his incredible record-breaking statistics. AKA was the first South African musician to gain 1 million followers on Twitter. He was also the first South African artist to be invited on Tim Westwood's UK show that paved the path for other South Africans to be featured on the show. The Supa Mega received 5 Best African Act nominations in 2015, showing his brand appeal as an artist dominating the African continent. In 2016, AKA inked a sneaker deal with Reebok, where he had his own custom-made sneaker. Only 600 were made and sold out within hours of release. He got paid roughly 120,000 rand every month for 2 years.
AKA is the first South African artist to create an iteration of the classic leather.
AKA received a WWE snacks deal. In 2018, AKA signed an exclusive partnership with Cruz Vodka to create a limited watermelon flavor. At every touch point, he wanted to be in touch with the South African nostalgia, hence following the flavors of the Chappies bubblegum for his Cruz flavored editions. Cruz watermelon went from a limited edition product to being one of the most sold in its category. Cruz banana followed. The bottle sold out in record time, but they made it a standard flavor. The deal saw AKA receive a share in the vodka's profit split per bottle sold throughout South Africa, which was a game changer in South Africa's spirit beverage industry. He has sold 1.2 million bottles to date. AKA became a self-made philanthropist in his later years of life. In 2016, AKA launched a scholarship in partnership with Bridges for Music and the School for Audio Engineering.
You know, I believe that education is a big deal in our country right now. You know, you look at the Fees Must Fall movement and the price of education, and you know, not everybody is privileged enough to be able to, you know, equip themselves with the, you know, the tools that they need to achieve their dreams. So
in 2017, he formed the AKA Foundation to help those in need. He donated to the Alex Fire. And in 2018, he created a challenge for young artists to design an album cover for Touch My Blood and made a proposition that the winner would get a one-year internship at Beam Group alongside his team of graphic designers. And in 2019, he became the first rapper to have his own comedy roast with Comedy Central. And with the student protests being at a high at the time, the rapper decided to donate the profits of his special to students. He donated 100,000 rands to the VITS SRC Humanitarian Fund and bought meals for students after having gone on a hunger strike over the high accommodation and registration fees. There's so much to be said about Kiernan Forbes that I had not even covered half of his achievements in this short documentary. He had such a larger-than-life persona. He exuded so much confidence from such an early point in the game. But that's because he believed in himself and his abilities so much that no one could tell him what he couldn't do. AKA gave a lot of artists a voice when they felt they could not have one. He cared so much about hip-hop. He knew that paying homage to those who laid the foundation for him was the right way of passage in hip-hop. To turn your biggest rap idols to friends said quite a lot about not only his musicianship, but his character in general. Kiernan demanded the best when it came to his brand. A perfectionist and a visionary. A principled individual who never shied away from being vocal and expressing himself. Super competitive and always pushing boundaries, we witnessed Kiernan evolve to an even better person. A loving father and devoted brother and son, AKA never shied away to shower love to those that he cared so deeply for. We appreciate his philanthropy, being the voice of the youth, caring about the youth, and being active in the constant struggle for youth employment. A heart so big that he always got excited to share his platform with up-and-coming artists. A patriotic star. He tied the South African flag around his mic wherever he performed and was first in line to publicly defend South Africa on any misconceptions made about the country. We thank him for choosing to follow his passion for music, producing club hits and wedding songs that help us create moments with those we love. You have made your mark, Supa Mega, sitting at the table as one of the greatest of all time. The truth. The soundtrack for the youth, there really is none greater. Long live Supa Mega, live long.
Just want to say thank you for all your support through the years. I've been doing this solidly now for 5 years and it's been a great ride. So I look forward to another 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, however many years with you guys backing me up and staying right there behind me. And, you know, my goal is to make you guys proud and with your support. Like Pinky and the Brain, I'm gonna take over the world.